Today, we will learn transfer characteristics of N-channel enhancement MOSFET using PSpice 9.1. It helps to understand the working of N-channel enhancement MOSFET. Above the diagram, you can see that two N blocks are diffused into a P-type substrate. Now, we know that in P-type, the majority carriers are holes and the minority carriers are electrons, whereas in the N-type, minority carriers are holes and the majority carriers are electrons. This comes into picture where you understand how the N-channel enhancement MOSFET works. What we mean by N-channel is we build a channel that joins these two N blocks, thereby connecting the drain and the source together. So, when a forward voltage is applied across the gate terminal, an equivalent amount of negative voltage is induced on the opposite side of the terminal. This makes it look as a capacitor, having positive charge on one side and negative charge on the other. Okay, when more or higher potential is positive potential is applied to the gate side, an equivalent number of negative potential, that is minority charges, are induced on the opposite side from the P-type substrate. This forms an N-channel joining the two N-blocks and connecting drain and source. This is how the N-channel enhancement MOSFET works. Let us now observe the circuit diagram. This is our N-channel MOSFET. This is the drain, the source, and the gate. We have two voltage sources, VGS standing for gate to source voltage and VDS standing for drain to source voltage. ID here stands for drain current. The drain current is formed when the N-channel is formed. Let us now learn the transfer characteristics of the MOSFET. Transfer characteristics can be referred to as the graph between the drain current and the drain to source voltages for different values of gate to source voltages. Okay, if you remember from a BJT video, we referred to as a left part of the circuit as input and right part of the circuit as output. Also, transfer characteristics are also known as output characteristics. With that logic in mind, it is easy to understand or to remember that transfer characteristics for a MOSFET is the graph between ID versus VDS for different values of VGS. All these lines or these curves here are for different values of VGS, VGS being 6 volts, VGS being 5 volts, 4 volts, and so on. It is still drain current versus drain to source voltage, but for different values of input voltage, that is VGS voltage. Let us now learn how to plot the transfer characteristics using the PSpice software. Let us now simulate the transfer characteristics for the MOSFET using PSpice. You can click this icon here to find new parts. M break N stands for the N-channel MOSFET. Okay, we click place and we place it here. You can press escape to deselect the selected items. Now we need two voltage sources, that is one is drain to source voltage and the other is gate to source voltage. Here the DC voltage sources are named as VDC. We click place and then place one here on either side basically. Then we are going to use a ground just to have one common potential for all of them. Please remember to select ground earth and not ground analog. We click place and then place it here. Escape. Now we close this. You can use this draw wire line or icon to connect all the components. Yes. Now, if you remember in the diagram, we are shorted this and this terminal. That is why we are shorting it here also. Now, we left this space here to bring the current marker. This is to find out the drain current. Now, you can press this magnifying glass to put everything into page. Let us now name the various voltage sources. V1 is V gate to source, VGS. V2 is V drain to source, so VDS. Now, we need to give different values of VDS and VGS because ID is automatically calculated. We can do this by using setup analysis, that is this blue color box on top. And then we hit DC sweep. Here, sweep variable type is voltage source, sweep variable type is linear type. It should always be linear. Name, since we are doing output characteristics first, ID versus VDS for different VGS. So since it is voltage source first, we're going to type VDS. Now start value can be anything, 0 volts to maybe 5 volts with increments of 0.2 volts. Nested sweep helps us to find the values of ID versus VDS for different VGS values. Again, so we select voltage source and linear, write VGS, start value is 0 volts to maybe 2 volts for increment values of 0.2 volts. It is very important to enable nested sweep here and press OK and we close it. Now we save this. Let us save this as MOSFET. Yes. Now when I hit simulate, this is the transfer characteristic for the MOSFET. ID versus VDS for different values of VGS as shown in the PPT. If you liked it, please like, share and subscribe. See you again in the next one.